brothers and sisters, and welcome to MTG Malone with me, Matches Malone. They did it. They finally did it. They banned the freaking ley line of resonance. Oh my lord, today is the most beautiful day. The most beautiful day of bannings ever. I told you. I told all of you. From day one, they will have to ban this. And they did. This just came in. I am so happy. There's so many reasons to ban this stupid ley line. Oh my god, I can't even put in words how freaking good that is. I mean, I want to show you. Now let's go to Twitter straight away. Why the heck not? You know, I said this. I said this numerous times. We will get to that very, very soon. First of all, I made this beautiful post right here. But let's just get to it. Let us just get to it. I posted this video. But they listened. They freaking listened. They listened to the community, and here it is. The reasoning why they banned the stupid ley line in best of one. In best of three, it has never been a problem. I played some best of three and it was fine. But it has been banned in best of one constructed, and it has been suspended in alchemy. I don't care about that either. So, we love fun, fast and fun magic. This is especially true for MTG Arena, where the guiding philosophy is fast, fun, magic for everyone, everywhere. Was this it though? Absolutely not. And here it comes. What's critical is that it be fast and fun for both players involved. Fast without the fun undermines the purpose of playing the game. And this is the issue with both we and the player community have observed with Leyline of freaking resonance. Good reasons to piece of... I don't even want to say it. I don't want to have Surdy have to freaking, you know, censor me here. But oh my god. When the ley line hits, you already feel bad. The second it hits, you already feel bad and you hate that game that you're in. It disrupts norm playing best of one constructed matches and has led us to the decision to ban the card in best one standard. I am so excited about this. Have you ever seen me this happy? Have you ever seen me this happy? I'm so happy. I am so happy. So, what led to the decision? Back in 2019, they made something similar for Nexus of Fate, with similar reasons. Made gameplay unfun through a long loop that couldn't be shortcut to the win. Laying on of Resonance had made gameplay unfun by making it so there isn't much playing involved. No freaking poop. No poop. Are you kidding me? I said this on day one. On day one. I said it. People were, you know, dunking on me. They were like, oh, you can just play removal. Yeah, right. You play an untapped land, you're dead. You don't know what happens in best of one. You just don't know. You don't know what the other person is playing. They could be having a, you know, a freaking Teferi avatar and a Liliana freaking sleeves and a rock pet. You don't know what they're playing. There's not written there the next game you are playing is going to be against Leyline. That's not happening. We're not in a format where that happens. That happens best of three. Okay, buddy. So, either folks playing Leyline of Resonant decks concede with their initial starting end because they're dissatisfied with the draw and are unable to mulligan down to a winning solution or to win within the first few turns of play. They don't even say it. They don't even say that it's on turn two. They don't even say it. This is especially problematic in best of one constructed. Where players on the opposite side of the battlefield win or lose the game and subsequently the match with little or no decision making on their part and no option to sideboard impossible solutions for subsequent skill games. I'm so excited, I can't even read right. No decision making on their part and no option to sideboard. That is the most corporate way to say you are not playing the game. You're literally not playing the game. You played one land. Oh, I hope you enjoyed that, because that is done. When Axe of Fate created non-interactive win conditions that would take half an hour or more to finish, Leyland of Resonance is creating non-interactive win conditions within 2 turns. Finally, they admit it. Within 2 turns, both disrupt what we consider normal play. Timing of the decision. This is the interesting part. We were all sitting here, come on, you have to do something, because we're only betting once a year. We're only betting once a year. But here it is. Here's the reasoning. Alongside fast and fun, another one of MTG Arena's guiding principles is to provide an authentic Magic the Gathering experience. This includes alignment. Well, to be fair, authentic, the Magic the Gathering experience cannot be had in best of one, because Magic was made for a best of three. So it is only logical that they ban in best of one as well. This includes alignment of ban and restricted announcements whenever possible to ensure the play experience is the same regardless of when, where, or how you play. Play on mobile is what they're saying. As we noted in our recent MTG Arena announcements blog, this is a card we've been keeping an eye on, with the goal to answer 2 essential questions. Does the data support Leyland of Resonance disrupting what we consider normal play? Yes. If yes, what I just said, yes. Is it happening often enough to warrant action on MTG Arena outside of our normal banning cadence? This kind of data aggregation and analysis takes time. They should not have printed this. This was the first mistake. The first week or so after a major card set release is often incredibly chaotic. And the meta can go through several radical iterations before settling on a new normal. Okay, yeah, I get this. For every screenshot or post shared on social channel, me, there are thousands upon thousands of other matches being played quietly in the background. That is true. But I play Wizards. Yeah, I play Magic for a freaking living. I do this every day in front of all of you. And I know exactly how many times I just don't include games in the videos. But if you are here on the stream, you see how many games against Mono Red going first I lost on turn 2. Nothing to do about it. We want to be sure that the problem shared with us by some of our most engaged players had the data supported, and the data continued to support it even after the meta settled. Okay. The answer to both of those questions were ultimately yes, and yes, a million times yes, I want to marry you, Wizards. The number of best of one standard constructed games ending before turn 4 has essentially doubled. Doubled since the release of Dustborn House of Horror. Before turn 4! It was already so crazy, because we had turn 3 wins consistently before this deck even existed. Jesus Christ, this number has remained consistent in the week since release. And there's a big, red, allegedly forecast enchantment reason why. Allegedly, you just banned it! Stop dancing around and just admit it, that this card was a mistake. With the updated ban and restricted announcement cadence, we didn't feel comfortable waiting until December 16th to make this change. I applaud you, Wizards. I honestly, wholeheartedly, from the bottom of my heart, applaud you for this decision. The Nadu ban, this ban right here, were some of the best decisions in the last 3 years of Wizards. The best decisions. This was genius. This was genius. People give Wizards a lot of crap. A lot of crap. They get a lot of, you know, angry people being annoyed about freaking everything. But this was the right decision. To be clear, this is an issue unique to MTG Arena and only standard best of one constructed in alchemy matches. That is totally fine. That is still a format that you are curating. That is still a format that you are providing as Wizards of the Coast to the community. You still want people to play that. So we absolutely applaud you for doing this. This was the right decision. This was the absolute right decision. And I love you for it. The banning is not based on general power level, but the overall health of standard format, far from it. That is right. It is not that the deck is the best deck ever. It is the most annoying deck to play against. That is the main reason why. People will now be able to put something else, but Elspeth Smite, not on my watch, cut down in their deck. Just insane. player collections and Leyline of Resonance. Well, you will be getting your rare white cards. That is what it says. That is what it freaking says. All of the rest down here is not important. This is the best thing ever to happen. This is absolutely the best freaking thing ever to happen, and I'm so happy about it. Seriously, the amount of times I complain about this card is more than the amount of times I have complained about not drawing lands or drawing too many lands. But that is nothing that Wizards can fix. Literally nothing. But this was something they could have fixed, and I'm so happy that they did. Just imagine the amount of times I have lost on turn two and there was nothing I could have done. I've never been happier than by beating people that played Leyline on turn one. Two Leylines on turn one. Why not? Why not, you know? Always into Scamp, into a freaking pump spell. It's ridiculous. And this was one of the best decisions that I've seen in the last few years from Wizards. So I really freaking applaud you. Wizards, this was a good freaking move. I love you for it. I literally love you for it. I posted something on Twitter or X or whatever you want to call it right away. I called for the ban. I called for the ban so hard. So freaking hard. This was just good, you know? I'm looking if I can see like the original post that I had. Because, you know, there was like a lot of people that were like, "Ooh, this is not going to get banned. Why should you ban it? Just play around it." I don't want to dance on anybody's parade. I'd make this post. If you get it, you get it. No standard format for me. I've been removed from best of one format's playable card pool by the Wizards team. We don't want to give upset parties the opportunity to play one tapped land, but their opponents win on turn two. What a reason. The mob won. If you get that one, hey, let me know. But here, can we please go back to this? So many people. Hey, Pleasant Kenobi. Come on, one of the people that is very, very amazing in this game. Was even like, you know, it's not that big of a problem. Skill issue, obviously. You could have played this and been on the play. Pick a better deck, win die rolls, draw better. There's literally an answer in your hand. If you didn't play a tapped land. You see what I mean? This is the only thing people can do. You know? What land should I have played instead? The forest? You said there was nothing you could do. That's clearly you're not through. You could have easily mulliganed to a turn one interaction since it exists in your deck. Do I really have to? Do I really have to mulligan everything until I find a freaking answer to this? This is kind of ridiculous. How consistently will this happen though? Consistently enough. You know, no game should win. Best of one is not magic. Okay, I see. Javelin said it's not a commander problem, so won't get banned. Why do you have so many tapped lands? If any of those was a plane or a pain land, you would have likely won the game. Magic players, sometimes it's turn two. Yeah, okay. Insane. Skill issue. Literally nothing. Have you tried playing removal or blockers? Vintage players laugh in unison. Vintage players laugh because they do have this problem, you know? The difference is you're playing an untapped land. You're playing a tapped land. They're playing an untapped land. I deserve to lose because of that. This is crazy. That people are like, hey, it's your fault for playing ban a 4-cat combo requiring two ley lines in hand. It works with anything else. I'm not showing you this to poop on any of these people. I'm just showing you literally magic players. Magic players will literally say it's fine because it didn't hit them yet. But Wizards was right to ban it. Come on. People are so happy right now. People are dancing on the street. People are freaking dancing on the street because of this. I am so, so happy. In my Discord, people are also dancing already. This is all I have to say though, you know? I'm so happy from the bottom of my heart that Wizards took the right decision. Everybody's saying that,
oh, you know, you just play interaction and then it's going to be fun.
Shut the freaking heck up, man. If you play 10 games, and 5 out of these games, thanks to something called the hand smoothing algorithm, people will draw into their good stuff so easily, you will not enjoy the game. Easy as pie. And all Wizards want is people to enjoy the freaking game. And this was so not enjoyable. Hey, I decided this was more important than a gameplay video. There will be a gameplay video again tomorrow, of course. We might see ley lines though, because I pre-recorded 4 more videos before this, but it doesn't even matter. It doesn't even matter. I'm happy. I'm so happy that they did what they did. They could not have brought like a better timing for this. This was just very, very good. So yeah, if you wanna see the banned and restricted announcements, of course, I will be hoping to remember to post the link. You can find it all there. You know, everything is here. No cookies, no thank you. I'm very happy. This couldn't have happened to a better time. It's very amazing. Of course it doesn't, you know, freaking involve best of three, which is fine. Usually in best of three, I won like at least 50% of the matches against this deck, even if they went first, because there was way to answer it. So yeah, that is all I have to say. So thank you all so very freaking much. I hope you enjoyed, and remember, my friend, that if you're waking up tomorrow morning and see a beautiful, beautiful face of yours in the mirror, that all of you are pretty freaking sweet. I'm MtgA Malone, and I will see you all tomorrow.